Hi, good morning to all. Today we are going to look at the topic is now principles for delegation. Whenever we delegate authority to our subordinates now, we need to follow these principles. The first principle is now functional clarity. The functions, methods, and the results of operations must be clearly defined. Clearly defined the above functions, methods, and the results of operation to our subordinates. The authority delegated must be adequate to ensure that these functions are well performed. The superior delegates authority to the subordinates now, along with the adequate information has to pass to the subordinates about the functions and methods now, how to work now. These details have to give to their subordinates. Matching authority with responsibility. Authority and responsibility are highly interconnected. Yes, it goes now together. Authority flows now top level to bottom level. Responsibility flows now bottom to top level. Both are highly now interconnected. Authority should be adequate now, should match the personal capabilities of the subordinate. The next principle is unity of command. Unity of command means we need to get the subordinates na get command from one superior. That is unity of command. A subordinate should be responsible to only one superior who is delegating the authority to the subordinate in the first place. Subordinate should receive command from only one superior. In this manner, the responsibility for mistakes or accomplishments is traceable and the chances of conflict or confusion are minimal. If we follow this unity of command, we need to find out the mistakes and accomplishments in an easy way. Then we need to trace it through which we have to minimize our confusion and conflict in the organization. Next principle is principle of communication. Both the responsibility and authority must be clearly specified, openly communicated, and properly understood. Superior communicates their methods and works to their subordinates clearly mentioned. And without hiding anything, we need to communicate to their subordinates. The lines of communication must be continuously kept open for issuing directions as well as for receiving feedback. The superior communicates openly to their subordinates as well as the subordinates communicate to their superior in open way. The superior also gets the feedback from subordinates. Then only the the delegation of authority would be successful. Principle of management by exception. The practice of authority and responsibility with management under the subordinates serves valuable time for top management that can be utilized for more important policy matters. Moreover, the superior delegates his authority to the subordinates to save the his time to utilize other matters. Other matters means they will spend a lot of time in policy making, planning and other meeting. Then only he delegates his authority to their subordinates. It's a temporary event. Delegation is a temporary event. When he comes back, he will take over the authority. Also, by trying to solve most of the problems by themselves, the subordinates prepare themselves for higher challenges and the responsibilities. Because the subordinates work instead of his superior. So whatever the superior have challenges and responsibilities, everything passes to their subordinates. So he will take care of their responsibilities and challenges in the place of his superior. If he does these things, he will experience in the field. Yeah, he will be a specialist also in that field. It is the main advantages of delegation. Thank you.